Discipleship requires us to be true followers of Christ. This morning, Jesus' journey mirrors a student's day at school. Jesus stands in the most human of places. Now he is wrongfully condemned to punishment by death. His commitment to entering our lives completely begins its final steps. He has said yes to God and placed his life in God's hands.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
You got a different look about you.
And by different, we mean weird.
Welcome to the school, weirdo.
Jesus is made to carry the cross on which he will die. It represents the weight of all of our crosses.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
With each step, he enters more deeply into our human experience. He walks in the path of human misery and suffering, experiencing its crushing weight.
Don't forget to turn in your assignments on Google Classroom. No late submissions.
The weight is unbearable. Jesus falls under it. How could he enter our lives completely without surrendering to the crushing weight of the life of so many on this earth? He feels the powerlessness of wondering if he will ever be able to continue.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Mom, I just wanted to hear your voice.
All his life, his mother had taught him the meaning of the words, "Behold, the handmaid of the Lord."
Please don't cry, Mom. I'm okay.
Her grace-filled smile blesses his mission and stirs his heart to its depth. Love and trust in God binds them together.
Thanks, Mom. Love you too.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Jesus even experiences our struggle to receive help. He is made to experience the poverty of not being able to carry his burden alone.
Office. Are you new?
Yeah.
I got lost my first day too. Let me show you where your next class is.
It's math. Thanks.
Right. He enters the experience of all who must depend upon others to survive.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
He's in this class too?
So let's make sure he leaves.
Let's take some pics.
Jesus' journey is at times brutal. He has entered the terrible experiences of rejection and injustice. He has been whipped and beaten.
Ignore them.
He encounters a compassionate, loving disciple who wipes the vulgar spit and mocking blood from his face.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Even with help, Jesus stumbles and falls to the ground. In deep exhaustion, he stares at the earth beneath him. Remember, you are dust, and to dust you will return. He has seen death before. Now he feels profound weakness there on his knees, under the weight of his cross.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
The women of Jerusalem and their children come out to comfort and thank him.
What happened?
Nothing.
You know? Both of you, come with me.
They had seen his compassion and welcomed his words of healing and freedom. Now they are here to support him.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
What?
Pictures of you and the calf.
I've had enough. I just want to go home.
The last fall is devastating. Jesus can barely proceed to the end. Summoning all this remaining strength supported by his inner trust in God, Jesus collapses under the weight of the cross. His executioners look at him as a broken man, yet paying a price he deserves. They help him up so he can make it to the hill of crucifixion.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Can you just try to finish out the day?
I don't know how much more of this I can take.
You two, my office now.
Part of the indignity is to be crucified naked. Jesus is completely stripped of any pride, and the wounds on his back are torn open again. He experiences the ultimate vulnerability of the defenseless. No shield or security protects him. As they stare at him, his eyes turn to heaven.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Did you study for the test?
No, I forgot. I totally slept in too. Oh my gosh.
You're gonna kill us.
It's only the first day. What did you do?
Huge nails are hammered through his hands and feet to fix him on the cross. He is bleeding much more seriously now.
That's messed up.
As the cross is lifted, the weight of his life hangs on those nails.
Congratulations. Now those two will never stop.
Every time he struggles to pull himself up to breathe, his ability to cling to life slips away.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Jesus surrenders his last breath. Into your hands I commend my spirit.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
He has truly died. A profound sacrifice is complete.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
The body of Jesus is taken to its resting place. The huge stone over the tomb is the final sign of the permanence of death. Oh, that our hearts might burn within us as we realize how he had to suffer and die to enter into his glory for us.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
Get helpline.
Hi, I need to talk.
If you should fall to